Hello, George. Welcome to the festival. How do you like it up till now?
It's been a wonderful festival so far. Really great programming and wonderful folks, of course.
And were there films that already inspired you or were special for you?
There were a number of films. I mean, all of the films, just interesting use of the documentary form, observational documentaries, documentaries that rely on the interview and the mixing of those forms, a documentary that mixed music video with observational. So just all these different formal approaches to documentary. It's been exciting to see that.
About your own film, you made the documentary Loa, Loa, you say, and it's about voodoo in Haiti. Can you tell in very short, what was your biggest motivation for doing it?
Yeah, almost all of my work is about indigenous peoples of the Americas and the history of colonization and post-colonization. And Haiti's a really important part of that history. The first of the European nations, the first revolution that you'd say is the first free country in the New World. You know, the United States really wasn't free for all of its citizens, but Haiti was. Haiti was the first free state, and from my perspective. Of course, I have to add, there were many indigenous peoples there that lived for thousands of years free, but the first European state.
How long did it take you to do the shooting for the film?
Yeah, the filming was just under 2 weeks, and then like 5 weeks to edit it after I spent a year putting the assembly edit. So a lot of footage in that two-week period in this kind of participatory mode, observational mode. So there was a lot of filming, and then having to sort of discover the story in that was the biggest part. You know, the post-production for me is a huge part.
Okay. Did you go to the masterclasses today?
I did.
Did you get there something that was really inspiring for you?
Yeah, I went to both John Apple and what was the other? I forget his name.
Jean Cunet.
I went to both of the workshops. They were great. Really insightful and sharing their perspectives on decades of documentary filmmaking.
Is there one tip that you take home?
You know, the talk on the use of silence in documentary, I thought was really smart and on point. You know, the idea of attempting to represent things beyond the limits of dialogue or someone telling you sort of in front of the camera, those moments of silence can be really powerful. And it was, he had some great examples, some great film clips to illustrate that concept.
Okay, what is your next film about?
I'm working on a number of films right now. One of them is about the history of the Indian residential schools in British Columbia. They existed all throughout Canada, but this is specific to a school in British Columbia and the Haida and Kwakwaka'wakw peoples that survived those schools. And at this point, I'd say are really thriving in a resurgence of indigenous cultures in that region of the Pacific Northwest. Haida Gwaii and the Kwakwaka'wakw territories. So that's one of the big projects and that I'm working on now.
Okay, I hope maybe one day we will see it here. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.